Afternoon, folks. Getting into the, back into this thing of my quitting smoking vlog. I'm gonna do this daily as long as I can keep away from them evil damn cigarettes. Let you know day to day how I'm feeling, what I'm doing to beat cravings, you know. How often I get cravings, this, that, and the other, you know. Just questions you may have, and me being accountable to y'all is kind of helping me with the quitting. Because really, that's the only way I can quit. I've just got to give them up. No nicotine patches, no Wellbutrin or none of that stuff. I just gotta give them up. No vaping. Now I've quit. Yeah, I've been smoking now since about 1983. So I can give you some insight on what it's like to quit. I've quit several times. I've quit once for a year, a couple times for about 6 months, bunches of times for a week or two. But this one's going to have to be the final one. I got to go in the morning and get a stress test. They think I've got some blockage somewhere. Having issues with my heart. Hopefully tomorrow we have the stress test, we figure it out. I do not like hospitals. But anyways, like I said, this is day two of me quit smoking. I had a cigarette now in about 36 hours. this is really your hardest stretch. From about 24 hours to about 72 hours is really your worst stretch. This is the one where the situational cigarettes are really gonna come up to creep on you. The one after dinner, first one in the morning with your coffee, the one in the bathroom, whatever, you know, one of the times when you're just, it's automatic, you had a cigarette in your hand. That's those, this, these 3 days here, this is when that'll really hit you. And you go do one of these things and almost feel naked if you don't have a cigarette. It's also during this times when my brain is trying to talk me out of it. Brains telling me, oh, you just smoke a pack. They don't hurt it. Just smoke one more pack and then you quit after that. And constantly have to talk yourself out of going to the store. But I found out after about 3 days, that starts letting up. It's really, from what I understand, is 3 days pretty much the chemical addiction is out of you. It's all physical addiction then. It's you're just used to smoking cigarettes. My body and smoking just don't get along. So, like I say, I already said why I gotta give it up. bills to keep them they've just come so damn expensive now too. It's paid seven something for a pack of cigarettes a couple days ago, and that was in one of the southern states. That was like up north. That's too much. It's especially somebody like me smoking three packs a day plus. Like I said, I'm coping. Usually in the truck, I'll keep Jolly Ranchers or those little Werther's Originals hard candies, caramel hard candies. I get to feeling too antsy, I'll pop one of them. Generally, that's enough to take to itch off and keep on going. Yeah, Jonesing pretty hard, but we can get through it. I treat it almost like baby steps forward. That little thought comes in the back of my head, you know. I'll just smoke you one. It'd be all right. You ain't gonna hurt nothing. What's one more? Been smoking for 45 years. Well, that's what you gotta beat to quit smoking. And like I say, the longer you can fight it, next thing you know, you'll be quit a week, and the cravings won't be near as bad. But I'll tell you from experience, they never go away completely. It'll go to where it's not a craving anymore. It'll be just a want, you know. After dinner, you'll just feel like something's missing, you know. Wake up in the morning, I wish I had a cigarette. Well, those are easy enough to fight. It's these first few days that are rough. Well, once you get through these first few days, it's a willpower thing then. How bad do you want it? Type deal. Y'all have you a good day. I'll check back in tomorrow and we'll see how I'm doing then.